All right, hey everybody. This is Ask the Jake. This is like the third or fourth time I've tried recording this tutorial, and I'm getting kind of mad because Hypercam is screwing me over. But this tutorial is going to be about syncing individual shots with Twixtor, like three or four shots on one clip. So I've already done this like four times in a row. So I'm just going to show you guys real quick what this is. This was requested by Trev, a co-leader of Acid. He's a nice guy. So I decided I'd do this for him. So if you guys could just like and comment on the video right now, comment on what you want to see. Alright, so I didn't know that I was going to play. But comment on what you want to see on the next tutorial and subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. So yeah, pretty much that's what we're gonna do, just sync more than one shot with Twixtor. So let's see here. I'm just gonna erase all the keyframes I made. So the first thing you're gonna want to do is you want to import your clip in After Effects. So I've done that here, and then you're going to want to import a song of your choice. And what you want to do to get this little audio, like the waveform, is you're going to want to double tap L on your keyboard. So LL, and that brings this up. And then if you want your audio levels, you can just go through the old-fashioned way. But double L is the key. It's the key shortcut for that. So to preview, so basically what I did, I just faded in the audio a little bit, and then I faded in the clip. And to fade in the clip, just click on your layer and hit T on your keyboard, and that brings in the opacity. You're just going to hit a keyframe for 100, and then a keyframe for 0, then one for 100. So that's what I've done so far. So to preview your audio, what you can do, instead of just doing a RAM preview every time, you can just do an audio preview. And you might have to go in your After Effects and look at what the excuse me. You might just have to look at your shortcuts and find out what yours is. But my shortcut is the period button next to my zero on my number pad. So I'm just gonna hit that real quick. So what that does, it just previews audio for you. And to insert a marker on the layer, like these little silver things you see right here, to do that, you just hit asterisk on your number pad, which is like above the one. That's what I have mine set up as. I'm not sure if that's how every version of After Effects is or not, but that's what mine is. You might have to just go into like you might have to go into help and go into like keyboard shortcuts and see what yours are, but yeah, I'm not positive what everyone's are. But yeah, hold on, my After Effects is being gay. All right, so yeah, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna do that for you guys. So right, so yeah, this is what comes up when you hit the shortcuts thing. I don't know why it just popped up. But come on, just close. All right. So yeah, I inserted the markers in there. The markers are not spot on with the thing. You have to like, I don't know, it's weird. You have to mess around with it, but don't put the shots right on the markers. So see how these ones are late compared to the other ones I have. All right. So what I'm gonna do is go in my clip, and what you want to do is line up your first. What you want to do is put your cursor over, like not this cursor, but like this one, the red line. You want to put that right where you want your first shot with your marker. So this is where I have mine set at, and already have. One thing you want to do is make sure you turn off your audio for that layer, because Twixtor doesn't keep the sound intact, so you have to do your own gunshots. So I have the gunshots already in place from before. But so I'm gonna go Twixtor. I already added Twixtor on. I'm gonna change the speed to 59.94, and then so yeah, so you just get your first shot synced with that little with where you want it to be, And then insert your Twixtor wherever you want. So we'll say right here's a good spot. So let me just speed. You just want to hit that and one, two, or whatever, and change your speed to I'll say two. And then say this little marker is where you want your next shot to be. I did not even open this. All right, so wherever you want it to be. So we'll say we want the Twixtor to end maybe about right here. That looks good. So then you have to go into your layer and then go to effects, Twixtor Pro, output control, and then put a little keyframe there. Then go forward two or three frames, whatever, and then go to 100. And then pretty much that just takes your speed. That gives you like this little Twixtor spot. So then you want to go to where you want your next shot to be. We want it to be right here. So what you have to do is you have to increase the speed. You have to like add a keyframe. Like you don't have to click that, but you just have to increase the speed so that it speeds up to clip to where your next shot is. So you just have to mess around with this and get like the right speed. So we'll just try like 390. So that's almost there. So that means we have to go a little further. So let's try 410. Not quite there. Let's try 440. Not quite there. 450. All right, not quite there again. So okay, 500. That's what we need. So there's a shot, and then you want to just go forward one frame, and then change the speed back down to 100. So basically, what you're doing by doing this is you're have your first shot synced, and then you have your Twixtor. So you have your nice and slow plus five. And you increase your speed back to 100 before the shot, and then you're gradually increasing the speed to like your next shot. So it'll go shot, slow, fast, and then you can make it slow again. So we'll find a spot where we want our next Twixtor. We'll say right here looks good. So just come over here to click to add a keyframe, then just go forward two or three frames, and change the Twixtor to two. And then we'll say we want the next shot to be right here. So we have to, change the speed back to 100 before that point. So we'll just do it right here. Looks good to me. 100. And then go to where your shot is. We'll say right here. And then what you want to do is duplicate your sound, your gun sound layer, and I'm just gonna drag this over to line up. And then you have to increase the speed. So that's almost there. A little bit more. So it looks like the shot's taking place right around here, so let's go a little bit more. Maybe the shot already did take place. No. So we're just gonna go 100. So that looks close. I'm not 100% sure, but yeah. So then we're just gonna go back to 100. And then we need to sync another shot. So it looks like the next place to sync the shot's going to be about right here, and it looks like the shot is already synced. This shot might already be synced. Can never tell for sure, but this is kind of like a lengthy thing to do. It just takes a good amount of time. So I'm not sure why this got real dark. T opacity's on 100. But yeah, so that's pretty much what you do, guys. Just gonna ramp preview this real quick to see how it looks. Okay, ramp preview, you can start anytime now. Oops. Let's try that again. I hate screen recording, it just makes my computer slow. That sucks. Alright, let's try this again. Sometimes, you know, RAM previews take a while to start. I don't know why, it's just how it works, I guess, so. First shot, slow. Second shot. Third shot. I'm not sure if that fourth shot is synced or not, but, so let's check it out. So yeah, guys, as you can see, they were synced pretty good there. Another thing that you might want to do is add in some motion blur, which I had in before. That kind of like covers up like the watery look whenever it like goes real fast. Some people may not notice it. I kind of notice it, so I always add in real smart motion blur. It's a great plugin. It looks great. So yeah, guys. I mean, that's about it. And also, if you don't want a Twixtor like in between the shots, you can always just go to like your next marker or whatever. Let me try and find the easiest way to explain this. You can always go in to like, let's see here. Instead of, see how I have the speed back up to 100? Now, say I wanted to sync the next shot like right here. This is just like, theoretically, if I wanted to do this, instead of putting like a slow part in here, I could just increase the speed or decrease the speed so that the next shot was like right here. So like, if you know what I'm saying, you don't have to make it slow. You can just do that so it gradually increases the speed to that point. If you understand what I'm saying, you don't have to like make it slow in between. So it kind of works like time remapping. That's another thing you want to do. Make sure you enable your time remapping on your clip so that you can make it like, so you can go like this. To do that, you just right click on it and go to time, enable time remapping. So that's about it, guys. If this tutorial helped you out at all, make sure you like the video. It really helps me. And comment what you want to see next and subscribe if you're not subscribed already, because that kind of is a big deal to me. Just that, like, I'm getting something out of putting my time in these tutorials. Yep. If this tutorial is kind of hard to follow, also, you can always add me on Skype. I'll have that in the description. And just leave a comment if you need help, too. So, this has been Acid Jake, and I am signing out. Peace.